The iPhone 5 has been out for about 4 months now. How's it holding up to scratches and blemishes? This is the iPhone 5 durability report. Let's get to it. Hey guys, it's Brandon Miniman from PocketNow.com. Now before I show you my iPhone 5 after 4 months of use, a couple of things I want to mention. Number one, I do not use a case. In fact, I don't believe in cases. I think they take away from the beauty and the functionality of a device, so I've been using the iPhone 5 completely naked for the last 4 months. Number two, I've never dropped this phone. I promise you, I've never dropped it on a hard surface. I might have dropped it on carpet, but who's keeping track? It has never hit the pavement. I promise you that. And number three, I haven't babied this phone, nor have I treated it roughly, kind of somewhere in the middle. I never placed the iPhone 5 in a pocket with keys or other hard objects to avoid scratches, but I don't place it perfectly on a tabletop like some people do to make sure that it doesn't touch any of the edges of the table or whatever. I treat it like a normal phone. Anyway, let's take a closer look at the iPhone 5 after four months of use. And of course, your results may vary. You might have an iPhone 5 that you've been using for 4 months that's in pristine condition, or maybe you're on the other end and it is beat to hell. So let's take a look at what I have with my iPhone 5. To start off, I would say that if I were to give this a letter grade, I'd give it a C, which is a pretty bad grade to give such a quality piece of machinery here. But as you're gonna see, there's a lot of problems with the iPhone 5's quality. Not build quality, but the way that they manufacture the device. I'm gonna start off here on the screen. If I tilt it just right, you're going to see a scratch here. Can you see that? And a scratch here, and there are many other surface scratches. The camera's having a tough time with that, but trust me when I say I've got a pretty deep scratch here, and a bunch of surface scratches that I cannot remove. Let's turn over to the back of the device. I've got this nasty nick down here that's right into the aluminum there. The anodized aluminum has chipped off, and then worse is the beveled edge. This chamfered edge is destroyed. Not destroyed, but it's pretty terribly marred. Around the entire device, you can see little nicks taken out. Look at that. Ugh, that is so bad. Taken out all around the device. And fortunately, I've got the white iPhone. If I had the black iPhone, it would be even more apparent because the paint would be chipped off, leaving kind of a silvery chip below the black anodization. So this is pretty bad, and it carries on the front too. Chips all around the device. And again, I haven't been throwing this thing around. And every single iPhone 5 I've seen, family and friends, the exact same thing is true. Chipped, chamfered edge all around. So overall, my iPhone 5 is not doing so well. I'm gonna give it a C in terms of the durability report here. Let us know how your iPhone 5 is holding up. Do you have chips? Do you have scratches? Do you have Mars? Let us know what it looks like, and even take a video of your iPhone 5 after 4 months of use or 3 months of use and drop it as a video response. We'd love to see how your iPhone 5 is holding up. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up, and of course, subscribe if you like our videos so you can find out when they hit first. Thanks for watching, and that's it for now.
Smartphones, tablets, wireless technology. If that's the kind of stuff that gets your flag waving, PocketNow has you covered. We've filmed over 2,500 videos, from in-depth reviews of the newest devices to special features like After the Buzz, to news and entertainment like the PocketNow Daily Broadcast and the PocketNow Weekly Podcast. And we're adding more every day. We've been around for over a decade, but the adventure is just beginning. Join us for the journey. Subscribe to PocketNow.